I am Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today, I'm going to show you how to set up external drive editing using LumaFusion version 3. Let's get started. Okay, so you're going to want to navigate down to the little preferences icon in the bottom right of the screen. We're in obviously the project view at the moment. You're going to navigate over to preferences and then navigate to advanced settings, and you'll see turn on external drive editing. It gives you some information about what you are doing. The external drive must be connected when editing projects with these external clips. This will not affect clips already added to projects. Pretty straightforward. Turn on external drive editing. Tap. And that's you. You're enabled. So you want to start using your external drive for editing purposes. Well, first of all, I'd say to get the best advantage out of it, you are wanting to use either a 2019-2020 iPad Pro and also the fastest SSD drive you can possibly afford. I know the Samsung, I think it's T7s, and the SanDisk 500 gig or 1 terabyte SSD Extremes are pretty good. I'm using the SanDisk just now, and it's plugged in and it's set up, and you can see it there. So if I go back into my media a little second and I scroll down to the bottom, I've got a folder called 51LF3 for LumaFusion version 3, external drive editing, and it's marked as local. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to press and hold on that, and I'm going to want to tap copy. I'm then getting up to 500 gigabyte SSD into media, into 2021, into LumaFusion video tutorials, and then from there, press and hold and paste. And that's going to copy across the video tutorials that I've already recorded, plus the graphics elements, plus the LumaFusion assets. And once they're on the SSD, I will then start to edit specifically from this drive. Aha, you thought the video was over. Here's a little sneaky bonus for you. I have got here my solid state drive, and you'll see I've now got clips missing. And the reason for that is that if I go into my files, this folder here was named local. Obviously, it's not local anymore to the iPad, it's on the solid state drive. So that's why I've renamed it SSD. But in the process of doing that, I broke the connection to the video clips. Now I've reconnected everything on 51.1, but I need to also reconnect on 51.2, I think, as well. No, not just 51.1, I've got 51.2 to reconnect. So to do that, highlight the video clip you want to drag onto your timeline, tap and drag it. Make sure it goes right the way around. You don't want it to go in the middle, right the way around. And then all you've got to do is tap replace missing media. That then adds that in. And in the case of number 3, because I haven't actually done any great amount of editing to it, you could do it this way as well, which is delete the clip and then just drag down the new version. That obviously needs to be fitted up again. So I'm going to do Option P, go to my frame and fit, go down to my 68.8 resize, and then also go to my audio. It's really nice to have these graphical representations, and also you can go in and load up like a Bruce Fry directly within LumaFusion depending on what audio filters you're running. What I'm going to do here is I am going to choose hard gate with a master quack for the ducking, and then shut that down, and there we have our clip in place. Now if we then switch these guys on, let's check everything's okay. It's looking pretty good. Shrink it all down, make sure our music's good, and then I can just...
Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today, I'm going to show you how to set up external drive editing using LumaFusion version 3.
And there we go. So that was just a little bonus, how to replace missing media if you do happen to disconnect your drive by renaming a folder or even a file. Any of these options will basically screw up your timeline. If you've liked this video, give it a thumbs up. If I've earned your subscription today, by all means subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to tap the bell, and that way you'll be notified of the next video tutorial. See you later.